Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk a little bit more about progressive web apps and the future of the Android market. Okay, so today I want to answer some questions. I got this one a couple days ago from Dario Radečić, who said, as you are the guy whose videos I watch about mobile development, I want to ask you some questions about the future of the Android and native apps in general. Number one, are native mobile apps still a way to go as an indie developer, passive income wise? Two, what are your thoughts of progressive web apps taking over the market? Three, with what types of in-app purchases have you had most success with? No games, only apps, remove ads, unlock content, etc. Thanks for the great quality videos. Looking forward to hearing your thoughts. Okay, so Dario, what I'm going to tell you is just my opinion, but I'm hoping other people put their opinions in the comments here too. But this is sort of based on my experiences so far and my hopes for the future, because I'm in the same boat that you are, you know, it's, you know, trying to make money from apps, having that passive income stream coming through. Your first question was, are native mobile apps still a way to go as an indie developer, passive income wise? Yes, absolutely. The reason I got involved with apps to begin with was because I love the way that you have the easy in-app purchases and the buying decisions are so simple. Like you don't get that a lot with SaaS projects or with web applications, where you might be able to use like PayPal and everything, but the in-app purchases is still the best way to go. And if you're concerned that the fact that, you know, mobile apps might not be there in a few years, just watch Google I/O next year. Watch WWDC. They're going to bring out some new devices. They're going to bring out some new APIs. They're going to want everybody to go in and use them. And there's going to be things that make all the applications that were done in 2013, 2014 really irrelevant, because you can do lots of new things with the applications. So it's always changing and it's always evolving. And a lot of people who were involved in the beginning are going to say, it's not the same, because it's not. The market is more crowded, but that doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It just means it's not the easy money that a lot of people think it is when they get involved. That's my opinion. Let me know if you guys disagree with that. But yeah, I definitely think there's a future in native mobile applications. The second question was, what are your thoughts of progressive web apps taking over the market? Now, I've done some videos about this before. I'm actually really excited about progressive web apps, but here's my biggest problem with them, right? I haven't talked to a single client or a single non-techie who knows anything about them or even knows what I'm talking about. So if I talk about, let's say somebody calls up and says, you know, Eric, I want an app, which, you know, happens a lot, right? And I say, you know, have you thought about doing a progressive web app? Nobody knows what I'm talking about. And they're not interested in that because everybody knows what the app market is, right? It sort of reminds me a bit of the iPod. So like, MP3 players existed before the iPod, right? You know, but it was sort of this thing where, you know, people would use MP3 instead of their Walkman or their Discman or whatever they were using back then. And even I had an MP3 player, right? And it was, you know, they were starting to catch on a little bit, but they were still very techie. They lacked the marketing where everybody knew what they were, right? When the iPod came in, everybody learned what MP3s were. When Napster came along, everybody learned about, you know, downloading music. And there were these certain moments where things sort of tipped and everybody knows what they are, right? When a client comes to me and they say, you know, I want an app, and they'll tell me something which I think should be a website, and I'll tell them, you know, this should be a website because there's no reason somebody would download this to their phone to only use it once, right? They'll still insist on an app because apps are exciting. Everybody knows what the apps are. Market is. Even if you say, I'll build you an app, and you build them a progressive web app, and you say you have to go to this URL, they're still going to say, why can't I see this on the app store? So what we have at the moment is a really good technology, but because it's not being fully adopted by Safari yet, and because, you know, it doesn't have the marketing backing and everything, I don't think it's really ready to get started. This is one of the reasons why I haven't got started yet on it. Anyway, right? And it's, you know, even the name itself, progressive web apps, is more descriptive than it is a name, right? It just doesn't roll off the tongue. That's my opinion. Let me know if you guys think there might be somebody out there watching who's doing really well with progressive web apps, and I don't know anything about it. But even in terms of like in-app purchases and stuff like that, I haven't seen the equivalent. It's not something I'm ready to leap into yet, but I've definitely done a lot of Hello World projects. Let me just say that, right? And your third question was, what type of in-app purchases have you had most success with? Remove ads, unlock content, etc. Now for me, I've done a video about this before where initially I was just releasing remove ads. That was my only in-app purchase. And I found that I wasn't getting a lot of people actually doing that. They weren't removing the ads because it wasn't important enough to them, right? It's not, you're saying, you know, it's gonna be the same experience but without the ads, which, unless your ads are really, really annoying, it might not be compelling enough for them to do it. They'll just put up with the ads. Now, when I started making content that was added onto it, then that was completely different. So like with the, okay, this is with games, but it was the language games where I would release like the first 5 levels for free. And then if they wanted to continue with it, then they could pay, you know, a one-off payment to unlock all the rest of them, right? With the Ear Agent, Ear Spy, we have like, you know, MP3 recording, things like that, you know, just that are just, they're in addition to the core application. So if somebody wanted to just use the free version with advertisements, that's perfectly fine. In fact, a lot of people, you know, they might not even have a credit card, they might not trust the process, all, you know, whatever, that's perfectly fine with me. But when I just released just remove ads, I didn't find that to work at all. And I think it's adding content onto it. I think that's probably the best strategy. And don't, if you have something that's working, don't remove the content, because let me tell you from experience, people will complain. You'll get a lot of bad reviews, people saying, this used to be there, but now you have to pay for it. So it's better to add functionality onto it and then, you know, and then release that as an in-app purchase. So, and for me, my whole strategy has always been free version with in-app purchases and paid version, so release both at the same time. This might be some of the trouble I'm having with Apple at the moment with all the container apps, but release 2 different versions, because some people don't want to mess with the in-app purchases. Some people would rather just, you know, pay a few dollars and just get everything at one go, and other people will make those in-app purchases. But anyway, those are just my answers to those questions, some of my opinions. Those of you guys who are watching, let me know what you guys think. Let Dario know what you guys think, because, you know, people just starting out, they might be interested in your guys' experience, and you may be more experienced about all this than I am. But so anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys on Monday.